Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Understanding Bode Plots. In this short presentation, we'll explain the fundamental principles behind Bode Plots and how Bode Plots can be used to analyze closed-loop response. Bode Plots were originally devised by Dr. Hendrik Wayne Bode when he was working for Bell Labs in the 1930s. Bode Plots are most commonly used to analyze the stability of control systems. In this presentation, we'll be explaining how Bode Plots are used when designing and analyzing power supply feedback loops. But there are many other applications for Bode plots, both within and outside of the field of electrical engineering. The advantage of using Bode plots is that they provide a straightforward and common way of describing the frequency response of a linear time-invariant system. A linear time-invariant, or LTI, system is defined as one that can change the magnitude and or the phase of a signal passing through it, but does not change the signal's frequency. The amount of magnitude or phase change introduced by a linear time-invariant system is usually a function of frequency. In other words, the change in magnitude and or phase differs depending on the frequency of the input signal. In this presentation, a practical example of a linear time-invariant system will be a DC-to-DC converter. Bode plots show the frequency response, that is, the changes in magnitude and phase as a function of frequency. This is done on two semi-log scale plots. The top plot typically is magnitude or gain in dB, and the bottom plot is phase, most commonly in degrees. In the past, Bode plots were often created by hand, but many modern instruments, such as oscilloscopes, can automatically create Bode plots based on measured values. An important advantage of Bode plots is that they show frequency response, that is, gain and phase changes, continuously over the entire frequency range of interest. We can use the information in a Bode plot to quantify the stability of a feedback system, and this is done using so-called phase and gain margins. Phase margin is measured at the frequency where the gain equals 0 dB. This is commonly referred to as the crossover frequency. Phase margin is a measure of the distance from the measured phase to a phase shift of minus 180 degrees. In other words, how many degrees the phase must be decreased in order to reach minus 180 degrees. Gain margin, on the other hand, is measured at the frequency where the phase shift equals minus 180 degrees. Gain margin indicates the distance, in dB, from the measured gain to a gain of 0 dB. These values, 0 dB and minus 180 degrees, are important because system instability occurs if these two values meet. Let's look at a couple of examples. Here, the measured phase at 0 dB is minus 135 degrees, so we have a phase margin of 45 degrees. The gain at minus 180 degrees is minus 9 dB, so we have a gain margin of 9 dB. Since we have a positive phase margin, this system is stable. In our next example, the measured gain when the phase is minus 180 degrees is plus 13 dB, so the gain margin here is minus 13 dB. At a gain of 0 dB, the measured phase is minus 215 degrees, so phase margin is minus 35 degrees at the gain crossover point, and this system is unstable. The reason that we refer to these as gain and phase margins is because they represent the distance from the points at which instability could occur. And generally speaking, the greater the distance, or margin, the better. Another way of saying this is that higher gain and phase margins mean greater stability. In the case of gain margin, we might be able to get by with a margin of zero or even less, but in this case, the loop would only be conditionally stable and could easily become unstable if gain changed. When it comes to phase margin, a typical goal is to have at least 45 degrees of phase margin, and even higher values might be desirable in more critical applications. In addition to safety considerations, performance is also affected by values that we can determine from our Bode plots. For example, a higher 0 dB crossover frequency usually means a faster response to load changes. And lower gain at higher frequencies means better noise immunity, or lower output ripple. One of the greatest advantages of the Bode plot is it can be used to quickly determine important characteristics of our system. There are other common ways of quantifying or measuring the stability of power supplies, such as load transient or step response tests. Although this method is well understood and widely used, it can be difficult to build a circuit to generate a fast load step, especially if there's inductance between the power supply unit and the load step generator. Bode plots offer several important advantages not found in this method. First, step response only shows large-scale behavior, whereas Bode plots can also show behavior on a much smaller scale. In addition, Bode plots can easily be made at different load levels or operating points. This is important because loop stability often depends on the operating point. Our supply might appear to be stable, but approaches instability under different load conditions. We measure closed-loop stability by determining the closed-loop response, which can be tested using the voltage injection method. In a nutshell, this method adds a very small resistor, usually on the order of 10 ohms or so, into the feedback loop. A point should be chosen such that the impedance looking in the direction of the feedback loop is much larger than the impedance looking backwards. A small disturbance signal is then injected across this resistor. This is normally done using a so-called injection transformer so as to avoid influencing the loop. The response is then measured and Bode plots are generated. Two different categories of instruments can be used when measuring closed-loop response. The first of these is a vector network analyzer, or VNA. A VNA usually has a very high dynamic range, which allows it to make very precise impedance measurements. However, one drawback to using a VNA is that VNAs are best suited for the characterization of 50-ohm components. Oscilloscopes, on the other hand, are already commonly used in the development of power supplies and allow direct characterization of noise and output ripple. And scopes can also make stability measurements, such as gain in phase margin, power supply rejection ratio, and step response. Let's walk through how we measure control loop response with an oscilloscope. We start with our power supply and control loop. To measure the loop response, we need to break the loop at some point to insert our disturbance signal. Recall that we want to choose a point where the impedance looking in the direction of the loop is much larger than the impedance looking backwards. We'll select this point, since here the impedance looking backwards is the converter output impedance, which is very low, in the range of several milliohms. We then place a small resistor at the injection point, and the disturbance voltage is applied in parallel to the injection resistor using a wideband injection transformer. The disturbance signal is created by the internal generator of our oscilloscope. The two channels of our oscilloscope are connected to either side of the injection point, and based on the measured values, the oscilloscope generates and displays the Bode plots. When measuring closed-loop response, it's important to use the right probes. The peak-to-peak amplitudes at our measuring points can be very low at some test frequencies. For this reason, 1x probes are recommended over the more common 10x probes. If we increase the signal-to-noise ratio, this also improves the dynamic range of our frequency response measurements. Another important tip is to use a ground spring, as shown here, or a very short ground lead, in order to reduce switching noise pickup and inductive ground loops. So in summary, Bode plots are extremely useful when analyzing magnitude and phase changes that are introduced by a linear time invariant system, in this case, the control loop response of a power supply. A Bode plot makes it easy to determine the phase and gain margins, which are important for determining system stability. Generally speaking, the more margin, the better. In order to test closed loop response with an oscilloscope, we break the loop, insert a small resistor, and inject a disturbance voltage using an injection transformer. We then measure the voltage across the resistor, and the Bode plots of gain and phase are automatically generated and displayed on our oscilloscope. This concludes our presentation, Understanding Bode Plots. Thanks for watching.